Hello everyone, so in the last video we have had a look on how to create a digital input source, a push button let's say, and when you press it down how it can create the connection between two terminals, let's say A and B, and how this 5 voltage will go through the connection and reach to the pin number 53. So now let's say I also said okay, when this is released, when you release the push, okay, when the switch is off, the connection is not existing there, right? Okay, in that scenario the connection is not there. So at that time what will happen is the 5 voltage will not go to the particular pin, right? Okay, so let's say this connection is not there. Okay, I'm tracing it. Okay, so at this time the connection is not there, so 5 voltage will be here, and at the point of A 5 voltage will be there, but at the point of B there is no voltage, nothing is connected. So let's say it's like a wire from the 53 is coming out of and hanging, and the hanging point, okay, the hanging point is B, so no connection is there. So this state is undefined, I already said you, because this is neither 0 or 5 voltage, neither 1 nor 0, neither high or low, so this is undefined. So I said you, we cannot keep a digital pin as undefined state before giving a digital input. So when you are pressing, you are giving a digital input as plus 5 and the 5 is going to 53. But when you are not pressing, or before you are pressing, this is in undefined state, which is line number 53. That means point B. So what I am telling you is, when you are not, before you are pressing it, still you cannot have it in undefined state. Okay, you have to have it either in 1 or 0. Okay, either in high or low. Okay. So, how you can get rid of this undefined state is something that I am going to explain now. Okay. So, what I will do is, okay, I will create a connection from here. Let's say this point. Okay, some point, we don't know which it is. Somewhere in the wire, C. There, what I will do is, I will connect a resistor first. Okay, so let's say resistor. Okay, so let's say a 1 kilo ohm resistor. 1 kilo ohm resistor. It can be any resistance almost. But let's say I am connecting 1 kilo ohm resistor. Then what I will do is, the other side of the resistor, I will bring down. And since I have plus 5 here, here I am going to have ground. I will tell you why. Let's just look at this. So what I will do is, I will connect the other side of the wire, resistor, to ground. Okay. Ground. Okay. That's fine. So now, if we check the current, let's say we didn't press the button now, okay, the button is in released state, no connection. So now what is the voltage, what is the value, or digital input value of 53? Okay, let's have a look. So here, okay, let's point the places. So this is C, let's say this point is called as D here. Okay, that's fine. So now what is the voltage value of A? That is plus 5, undoubtedly, because here it is plus 5, so throughout the wire plus 5 will be there. The terminal A will be plus 5 voltage, that means high 1, but there is no connection, so B will be, now let's, we don't know what's the value. Okay, that's fine. C also we don't know, this place, okay, let's name this place, okay, that's not a problem. The C and this place are same, right? Okay, so let's have this place as E then. Okay, this is E. Okay, so E also we don't know. Let's come down and come here at the point D. So point D will be 0 voltage, right? That means ground. Yes or no? Yes. Why is that going to be in 0 voltage? Because ground is 0 voltage. So point D is directly connected to ground. So then, if we go upside, okay, there's a resistor. After the resistor, we have the point E, right? Okay, so what is the voltage value of the point V? Okay, what is the digital value? So, just remember, if there is no current running through a circuit, okay, if there is no current running through a circuit, everywhere throughout the circuit, the voltage will be same. Okay, so what does it mean is, I will explain that later, but still just know that, okay, if there is no current is running, voltage will be same. What does this mean is, in the line number 53, okay, line number 53 to C, and we go to E, and we go up to D. Okay, so D is ground, E we don't know. E is connected to 53 in an undefined state. Okay, so if there is another thing is, if there should be some current passing through, okay, let's say you have a battery, okay, plus and minus terminals, okay, if we need a current passing through a circuit, we should make sure the current, there's a voltage difference also, and the current should come back to where it started. Yes, no? So the positive terminal we started and my negative terminal we came. Okay, that is one thing. And also here in this circuit, there is no such thing. But the main thing is, yes, the 53 is not a power source at all, voltage source. It's an undefined state and it is going to ground. So you can imagine there is no current running through this path. Okay, there is zero current running through this path. So what does it mean is, since there is no current running, where in this path, okay, in this path, since no current is running in this path, no current is running, the voltage throughout the path will be same. Okay, if I was wrong with this explanation, if I was wrong, like, don't worry, just think like this, because I'm maybe a little bit confusion with electrical things, that's okay. In this pathway, okay, you may think there's no battery or something, right? There's no plus 5 and ground, there's no voltage source and ground. This 53 is some undefined state, we don't know, and there's a ground. You can assume in this pathway, okay, which pathway? In this direction, pathway, there's no current is going to flow. Especially the current going, if there's current that is going out from this source, will not come back to this place again. You can think like this, okay? So it's going to ground. Like that, okay? So if it is confusing, just remember this circuit current is not flowing. So since there is no current flowing this throughout this circuit, as I said, if there is no current flowing within throughout a circuit or across the component, everywhere same voltage will be there, okay? So we know in D the voltage is zero, so the same will be in E because no current is flowing. Okay, so same voltage will be in E, but it's zero. The same will be in C also. Yes or no? Yes. The same will be in 53 also. You understand this? So the zero will be in 53. So let's say in initial state, if you don't press the button, now the voltage value of the 53 is zero. Or in other words, it is in low state. Okay. So zero voltage, zero or zero voltage, low state, all are same. Okay, so now you see there is no undefined state when the button is not pressed. When the button is not pressed or at an initial state, the 53 is in ground state, because here we have a ground connection now in the circuit. Yes or no? Yes. So this ground will be going here. So initially the 53 will be in low state. Okay. And also, I forgot to mention, B also, zero voltage. Okay, that means low state, ground, zero, high or low, low, 1 or 0, 0. Why? Because C is also zero, B is also zero, and we didn't press the switch, so up to B, the zero will be existing everywhere, here, up to here, and also downside here. Everything will be ground. And just quickly telling, before I moving to the next video, when we press the button, everything will become 5 voltage. Just don't worry about that. Just understand now how we have got rid of the undefined state when the button is not pressed. Or let's say how at the initial state we have got rid of the undefined state is like this. Okay, we made it low. Okay, so I will catch you up in the next video, guys. Just follow me up in the next video. Until then, stay safe and consider subscribing us.